Welcome to chapter 8 of the video tutorial. The topic today is tables. And I'm going to create a table by clicking on insert, clicking on the table icon. And here's a very neat way of creating a table automatically. Straight away it's done. Now the table can actually be moved around by clicking on this section, this handle. It can also be resized by clicking on that handle. Yeah, now the table is actually consisting of rows that you can select individually, and also columns that you can select individually, or you can select separately by pressing the shift key clicking the shift key for consecutive rows and columns. Shift, if I wanted to select two rows independently, I would press the control key. If I wanted to select, let's say, two columns separately, I would press the control key followed by the left mouse click. So what does that allow me to do? Well, watch, I can right click and I can change the shading. Okay, change the shading to a particular color, say blue, or let's say green. Let's choose this nice looking green. There you go. I can also select the rows independently of each other. Okay, let's just change the borders to red, and we can change the style to, let's say, 30%. Okay, you can also fill the inside of each box by moving the cursor inside the cell. Each box is called a cell. So when my cursor changes into this little small but diagonal icon, I can select a cell. If I were to press the control key, I can select cells independently of each other. I can also change the borders. Change the border, going to border tab, change to 3D. Okay, there you go. What else can you do? Well, you can also change the width and height of each cell independently from the rest. For example, like this and like this. Yeah. And if, let's say, I'm not happy with that, I want to make all the cells to be equal border, equal size, what I can do is just go to borders and shadings, just click on all. There you go. And now right click, distribute rows evenly, distribute columns evenly. Another thing that you can do with tables is to merge cells together by clicking and dragging and selecting two or more cells, right clicking. Click twice, once at the beginning to create a selection. Once a selection has been created, click again second time. Now here comes the shortcut menu. Nope, we don't want that. What I want to do is to merge the cells. So here I can merge the cells. So the two cells become one cell. Let's just prove that by changing the borders, changing the border color, which actually I can choose this icon up here. Not that one, sorry. Design, border, shadings. Here you go. There you go. So I can change the colors if I wanted to. And here and here, let's change that. Two consecutive cells. And it's just two separate cells. Let's press control key, and let's choose red shading. Okay, so that's one part of tables. Another thing that you can do with tables is that you can actually insert rows and columns above and below each row, or to the left or to the right of each column. So for example, let's say I select this column, right click, insert columns to the right. I can also select the entire row, right click, insert row above. So this is pretty useful when creating tables. Yeah. One last thing that I want to show you is the direction of the text. Let's say I type this, the ant was clever. Is it possible to change the orientation of the text? Now let's just make this text much bigger. Okay. And let's go to select the entire sentence. Go to home, sign, see now layout. Yeah, here you go, layout. So under layout, what I can do is I can actually change the text direction by clicking on this icon. There you go, I've changed the direction of the text. Let's just make it a bit smaller so that we can see this. There you go, that's the text that that I created. Now it's been the orientation has been shifted 90 degrees, so that it's standing up on its side. Yeah, now I can also do things like this is a test. Now you look at this icons here in the alignment section. Well, guess what, you can actually align them in so many ways. There's 9 ways that you can align the text. This is to center everything. This is to center all the text within that cell itself. So that's pretty useful. Okay. Another thing you can do is to merge. Of course, after merging a cell, you can also split the cell. You split it into 4 columns by, let's say, 2 rows. So let's see what happens. Wonderful. See that? The entire cell has been split into so many cells. Okay, so that's a little bit on tables. Of course, the thing that perhaps I should mention is the borders. Very complex. Creating borders, you can actually each line itself can be formatted. Yeah, for example, let's say it's like the width of the line, 2.5 points. So we can actually select individual lines to have different properties like this. Okay, and it's very flexible. One thing about Microsoft Word is that the features are very, very user friendly. Very user friendly. Okay, that's all for tables. Thank you.